Omaha's news leader, chronicling the stories and people making a difference in our community. This is KETV News Watch 7's Chronicle.
It's just fun. The fans are great.
I think it'll be a fun time to get to meet people from all over the United States and bond over the fact that we're celebrating baseball.
It's by far our busiest time of the year. I mean, you just don't have, you know, an event where you can just fill up a, you know, a space this size, you know, just day in, day out for, you know, for two straight weeks. So, yeah, we gear up for it.
And good morning. Welcome to KETV News Watch 7's Chronicle. I'm Rob McCartney. It's that time of year once again. The College World Series is back in Omaha. Thousands of people from all over the country come here to see the biggest event in college baseball, the greatest show on dirt. Well, this morning on Chronicle, the business of baseball, the CWS's economic impact on the city, Omaha's relationship with the NCAA, to how it helps keep people living here. First, though, we want to talk food. One of the biggest parts of catching a game is all the treats you can eat, and there are a lot of them.
I'm Chris Myers, executive sous chef at TD Ameritrade Park. Just introducing some of the new items we have this year. We have a couple new hot dogs. We have the Wonder Boy hot dog, which is a quarter pound hot dog, and it is has a cabbage relish on it and mustard, whole grain mustard, Gruyere cheese. We have what we're calling the hot dog sandwich, trying to prove that a hot dog is a sandwich, basically a BLT with a hot dog. So what we're saying is if you take the hot dog off, does that make it a sandwich? If you put it back on, does it cease being a sandwich? Of course not. This has bacon, lettuce, tomato, provolone cheese, and herb aioli, and a pickle. Back this year is our colossal tot. We're doing a new version of it. It is Italian with marinara, sausage and peppers, and of course Parmesan cheese on top. It's 1 pound of potatoes. We do a countdown with that, a countdown clock behind the concession stand, so you kind of have to get here early if you want one, because they move pretty fast. So. 50 per game. Yeah. This is our new Grand Slam Nacho, and that will be available in the outfield stands, and it has a braised Baja beef on it, queso blanco, jalapenos, pico de gallo. Just kind of a cool, larger version of our nachos here. And of course, pork wings right over here. Yeah. The pork wings are three pork shanks, some jalapeno and onion petals on top of those. That's our charcuterie for grab and go section up in the club area. So if you're into something a little bit nicer with cheese and meat, and crackers, basically what that is.
Wonderful.
What is it called? What do you
mean? I'm eating the tacos. There's beef and chicken.
I had a lot. I had a taco and a hot dog, and I tried the fries, and then I had some of the tort at the end for dessert. It was really good.
I had the hot dog sandwich. I had a beef taco. I had some lobster fries, ground beef burger, and nachos. Basically everything. Then it ended with a tour. My favorite was probably the lobster fries.
I had pretty much everything on the menu, but I'll tell you what my favorite thing was. Lobster truffle fries. Seafood lovers will enjoy it.
My favorite was the pretzel bites, just because I adore pretzels and you can't go wrong with adding cheese and like meat on top of that.
My favorite, the pork burger that has fried apples, rosemary, peppered bacon, barbecue mayo, cheddar cheese, pickles on a pretzel bun. So that's usually, that's the one I'd choose probably. There's a team of us and we start working on it. Like, we're already thinking of items for next year actually. We started testing items in January as when we have time. We're super busy so we don't always have a lot of time. So whenever we can find that half hour to, hey, let's throw this in the fryer and see what happens kind of a thing. That's kind of how it works. And then you have to start getting serious about 3 months out during the Creighton baseball season. We can test some items in different concession stands and kind of see how they go. Everything's prepped ahead of time, but as fresh as possible. So like the pico de gallo for the nachos, that gets made every day. You try to have to gauge how much are we going to go through today, how much did we go through yesterday, and base your pars off of that for the next game. Fanfare's the colossal tot's a big one. I think that the pork wings are going to be pretty good. Of course, the nachos. Everybody loves nachos. So I think that our new version of the nachos will go over pretty well. It's fun. I mean, it's really that simple. You get to throw a whole bunch of things against the wall and see what sticks, basically. And when you come up with something that's different than everyone else is doing, that's kind of the payoff of it.
Well, College World Series in Omaha is a tradition. It's been here since 1950. Every college team dreams of getting on the road to Omaha, NCAA's crown jewel of baseball, as we mentioned. And with me this morning is Ann Clendenin. She's from the NCAA. She's the Assistant Director of Championships and Alliances. Ann, thanks for being here.
Thank you so much for having
me. Let's talk about alliances. Talk about the relationship the NCAA has with Omaha.
Of course. I mean, 70-year relationship. Yes. How about that? So for us, we love coming back here every June to get back to the community and the family right. that supports us so wonderfully every single year. Right. So it's just not only for the NCAA staff, but for the college baseball fans around the country. I mean, this is the mecca of college baseball, and the community and all the folks in it and their surrounding cities are phenomenal. Right. It's wonderful to come back and, you know, feel that welcome with open arms just to be here.
So Omaha loves it,
yeah.
And Omaha, and we'll talk about it later on, gets a lot out of it. What sure. does the NCAA get out of it being in Omaha?
We just enjoy the city so much, and we enjoy the region so much as well. To be able to come back and work with the same local organizers year after year, to have those relationships established and those roots here allows us just to continue elevating the student athlete experience. The teams come in, it's always just the road to Omaha, and it's so important as part of college baseball to make it here to the Mecca. So for us, as we're planning and working with so many local entities, College World Series of Omaha and Incorporated, the CVB, as well as Mecca, the city, and so many other wonderful organizations. It's just great to have those folks on the other end of the table who we know and can just continue to elevate the fan and the student athlete experience year over year.
But why Omaha? I mean, there are a number of cities you can go to. You have been courted by exponential number of cities. Why Omaha? What was it in the first place, and why are you still here?
The tradition. How could we get away from 70 years of tradition, first out of the Rose, you know, going from Rosenblatt to TD Ameritrade Park, Omaha? For us, it's just what every college baseball fan looks forward to. Start of the season, all the way through postseason, and then the series is just making it here. Such a wonderful part of the country. And just moving away from that, we would lose all the tradition that has been established here. Why would we? We just love coming.
Is the central location? Is it the, I mean, you mentioned the people. What are some of the tangibles, I guess, that you guys look for?
Absolutely. So I think for us, just the ability to, again, it comes back to relationships. It comes back to the ability to really plan and take an event to the next level. So for us, knowing the community, knowing the needs of the community, the opportunities that exist. For us, it's the ability to sit down and say, what does the series look like this year? And what are the folks, what are they wanting to do and experience when they come out to town? So for us, it's working with, again, the local organizing community to start looking at areas of need and the opportunity to serve and continue serving the community. So for us, as we start planning, we take a look at, okay, what's going to be exciting for the people who return, but also the local fans. And for us, we get such great feedback and such great support. It just trying to replicate that year over year would be extremely difficult for us. It goes from the top to the bottom, I think, in what we're able to do each and every year to elevate.
So it's been like 10 years ago, I believe it was almost 10 years ago, TD Ameritrade was built. And that really was crucial for the series staying here.
Yes.
Why? What was the inside baseball, to use that analogy, here that made TD Ameritrade have to be built to move it away from Rosenblatt?
I'm probably not the best person to comment on that one in particular, but it all comes back to the student athlete experience and just really what they're able to see and do when they come in to compete at a national level for the biggest title that there is, just to be a crowned national champion. So for us, I think their experience, superior opportunity for fans to come in and see a beautiful stadium and compete, see the competition on the field, but also to be able to be at a city that welcomes the series so much, fans and student athletes. I think part of bringing it downtown is just the location in and of itself and all the amenities, both at this new stadium as of 9 years ago, but also just the what's walkable, Old Market's so close by, everything's booming downtown. It just really truly makes for a good experience. There's airports super close to bring student athletes in and out. So just the amount of hotels, it really becomes a good landing spot for us. It's easy to get in, it's welcoming, and those are all the things that we love to see as we're bringing folks into the city.
There's a lot of people obviously here who don't want to see it go away. What are the chances that Omaha could lose the College World Series?
Oh, I don't think there's any chances.
No chance.
Not for me. No, absolutely not. I mean, for us, again, we just love being here. And it's such a great opportunity working with the folks at CWS of Omaha Incorporated and bringing it back every year. I don't think there's a better experience out there for college baseball fans. Again, Omaha's the Mecca.
Right.
And to be able to come back is just big opportunity.
I think everybody agrees. Actually, we just heard from Coach Martin earlier this week, said it, basically everybody wants to come to Omaha, not just because this is where the series is, but because it's a great part of the country.
Yes.
And then I want to ask, finally, is there anything new and different or exciting for the fan experience this year?
Oh, of course. And whether you're a repeat fan or you're a new fan, I've never even been to College World Series. We have so many new opportunities this year that we're excited about. So you've heard of our opening ceremonies and opening celebration day.
Yep.
New this year, fans who come down, for that, we'll have a great time and we'll have seen Eli Young Band and fireworks and just seeing that all in of itself, opening of College World Series and Fan Fest presented by Capital One and all the great interactives we have as part of that is huge for us. But really what I'm excited to share with you for the community in particular are our theme nights that we have new this year to honor first responders. Kids Day, of course, and then our military. So for the first time on Monday, tomorrow, it'll be fantastic because what we'll do with that day on, I want to say it's June 17th in particular, Game 5, we're offering half off general admission tickets to all first responders and their families. With all that's happened in locally with flooding and severe weather, it was just a way for us to lift up and honor those who serve and enjoy them. So there'll be a number of recognition, again, half off general admission tickets pricing, which will be fantastic. Mm-hmm. So we're excited about that one. Kids Day, new this year, will offer half off tickets for kids 12 and under.
Nice.
And again, just a great opportunity for families who may not have come out to the series to check it out with their family and friends. And then new this year, kids 12 and younger, after the game, we'll get to run the bases. And that's Wednesday the 19th.
Awesome.
So we're excited for that one. And then finals game one on Monday the 24th, we will have half off for military, active, retired, reserves, and veterans and their families for everyone to come out and have a great night at finals game one. So really giving back, really want to embrace the community and just let folks come out and have a great time, enjoy college baseball at its highest level, and just get away from the everyday distractions.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And thanks very much. Great, great event, and good
Thank
luck with the rest of the series.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
You bet. Well, still coming up this morning, KATV News Watch 7's Chronicle.
The College World Series is a key point of why hotels want to build here.
And we're going to take a look at the economic impact on hotels, why the market is a little unbalanced. You're watching KATV News Watch 7's Chronicle.